Hi, this is Nageshwar Rao, Assistant Professor of Physics, Government Degree College, Chintalapudi. In this presentation, we will explain change of phase on reflection when the ray is reflected at the denser medium. We know according to the Stokes, when a light ray is reflected at the denser medium from the rarer medium, it suffers a phase change of pi radian. It means the path difference is lambda by 2. So this is called Stokes' law. In this presentation, we will prove this. Where this medium 2 is the denser medium than beta medium 1. AO is a ray which is incident on the denser medium and partially reflected along OB and partially reflected along OC. So this is the normal drawn in this diagram. This is OB is the reflected ray, OC is the transmitted ray. If the ray is reflected at the rarer medium than the from the denser medium, there is no phase change occurs. So as shown in this figure, the medium 2 is the denser medium. It is nothing but whose refractive index is greater than the medium 1. So AO is the ray is incident at O and is partially reflected along OB. If A is the amplitude of the incident ray and R is the reflection coefficient, then the amplitude of the reflected ray is AR. It is partially transmitted along OC. If T is the transmission coefficient, then the amplitude of the transmission coefficient is AT. So here, medium 2 is optically denser medium than 1. So the wave is partially reflected along OP and partially transmitted along OC. Already I told you, if R is the reflection coefficient, then AO is the incident ray having amplitude A reflected along OB. Then the amplitude of the reflected ray is AR. It is partially transmitted along OC. If T is the transmission coefficient, then the amplitude of the transmitted ray is AT along OC. If this reflected ray and transmitted ray whose directions are reversed, then what happens? For example, transmitted ray OC is reversed. It is reflected partially along OD and transmitted along OA. Similarly, the reflected ray OB is reversed, that is BO having amplitude AR, partially reflected along OA. We know R is the reflection coefficient at a denser medium, so the amplitude of the reflected ray is AR into R, that is AR square. Similarly, there is partially transmitted along OD, so that the amplitude of the transmitted ray is AR into T, that is ART. So this can be written as here like this. So suppose the direction of the reflected and transmitted waves are reversed, so that AR into R, that is AR square, is the amplitude of reflected ray, and AR into T is the amplitude of the transmitted ray along OD. So if R dash and T dash are reflection coefficient and transmission coefficient, when the ray is traveling from denser medium into the rarer medium, then so CO is the transmitted ray is reversed, then it is partially reflected along OD. We know reflection coefficient is R dash, so that the amplitude of the reflected ray is AT into R dash, that is AT into R dash. It is partially transmitted along OA. If T dash is the transmission coefficient, then the amplitude of the transmission coefficient E transmission ray is AT into T dash, that is AT T dash. Of course, I told you BO is again reverse, that is along it is OA and along OD. Now, the transmitted ray along OD due to the CO ray is AT into T dash, that is AT into T dash. Actually, there is no wave along OD in the diagram 1. So that there is ART plus ATR dash is 0 because along OD there is no wave. It is nothing but R is equal to minus R dash, where minus represents the phase difference between incident ray and reflected ray is 180 degrees, that is opposite each other. Actually, the amplitude of the AO ray is A, but there is two rays, that is ATT dash and AR square. So that AR square plus ATT dash is equal to amplitude, that is original amplitude. From this, ATT dash is equal to A minus AR square, so that TT dash is equal to 1 into 1 minus R square. As shown in equation 1, negative sign, that is R is equal to minus R dash, where this represents the phase change of pi radian. Either reflection occurs at the denser medium or either reflection occurs at a rarer medium. But Lloyd's single mirror experiment shows that when the ray is reflected at the denser medium, the central fringe is dark instead of bright. It means that the phase change occurs by pi radian, or path difference is changed by lambda by 2. So this is only possible when the light suffers a phase change of pi on reflection at the mirror, that is at the denser medium. So this shows that a phase change of pi is introduced when the reflection takes place at the source of denser medium. This is the proof of the Stokes' law. Thank you.